गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. चैप्टर नंबर 8 स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स वी हैड स्टार्टेड लास्ट वीक. एज वी ऑल नो द फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स दे आर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स, वन विच इज फाउंड अंडर द ग्राउंड, वन द अनदर वन विच इज फाउंड अबव द ग्राउंड. द पार्ट विच इज फाउंड अंडर द ग्राउंड इट इज नोन एज root system, whereas there are many parts of the plant which is found above the soil and they make a system known as shoot system. In the topic root system, we had discussed about the roles of the root, absorption and fixation, and then we had discussed about the classification of root depending upon its origin, shape and their structure, that is tap root system and fibrous root system. After that, we had discussed about the different modifications of root, in which we had discussed about the prop root for additional support, then sucking root for deriving food from the other plant or the host body, and the root which is modified for storage purpose in the case of carrot, radish, turnip. After that, we had discussed about the main part or the strongest part of the shoot system, that is stem. The stem is the strongest part of the shoot system, and it is also known as trunk in some cases. The trunk is covered with a protective layer which is mostly brown in color, and that protective layer is known as bark. Each stem carries nodes. Now, what is node? The node is the place from where the leaf arises. It is a type of outgrowth which is found on the stem, and not only one, there are numerous or various numbers of nodes found on the stem. It has been seen that between two nodes there is a space, and that space is known as internodes. And after that, we had discussed about the main function of the stem as well as the special or extra function performed by the stem under the topic modification of stem. Now you can see I have kept a stem in front of me. This is a stem. Just have a look on this stem, and the leaves are present on it. Now just check this portion, this outgrowth or granules like structure. This is actually known as the nodes from where the leaves arise. Okay, these are the area from where the leaf arises. I'm showing you here, small one I have. Let's check. Can you see this? And just to check this. This is the node from where the leaves arises. Check. The milk-like structure is coming out. Not only one, but if you pluck the leaf, you will see that they are attached with the stem at one place, and this space is only known as node. Now just you see the region between two dots or nodes, first one and this is the another one. The space in between the two nodes, it is known as internodes. Okay, so this much topic we had already discussed in our previous class about root and stem.
it is all clear, and we had discussed each and every part under this topic. The next one is the leaf, but before that, let me recapitulate the structure of leaf that we had already learnt something, some very little topic about in standard 3. Now just you check, this is the flat portion of the leaf. This is the flat portion of the leaf which contains a central line, okay, which contains a central line, and then this central line is connected with many lateral lines. Okay, this is known as leaf, and leaf is the kitchen of the plant that we all know very well. The leaf is green in color due to the presence of the chlorophyll, that also we know. The chlorophyll is the pigment which makes or which gives the leaf green color, and it also helps in the process of photosynthesis. On the leaf there are very small openings which cannot be seen because they are very small. So that small openings, which are known as stomata, it is present on the leaf surface. These stomata help in capturing the sunlight. The chlorophyll help in capturing the sunlight, and then stomata opens. Clear? When the stomata opens, gaseous exchange takes place, and then only the photosynthesis takes place. Okay? So let's start the discussion about the leaf. Let's discuss the further discussion about the leaf. As we all know, the leaf is green in color, and it is attached to a portion on the stem. This is a stem, and we all know this, that this is a diagram of leaf. The leaf is attached on a stem, to a stem, on a point, and this point is known as node. Clear? So node is the region where a leaf is attached to the stem. Now the first question comes in our mind, that what is leaf? Leaf is the green colored part. It is the green colored part of the plant, and it is flat as well as broad. Now what is the meaning of flat and broad? Flat. Now you can see it has a flat surface, chapta, and broad means just to check the width. Iski chaudai ko check karo. It is mostly or generally flat and broad in shape. These leaves which are attached to the node, it has been found that the younger leaves, it grows at the upper part of the stem, whereas the older leaves grows at the lower part of the stem. आप किसी भी पेड़ पौधे को देखो जिसके नए पत्ते होते हैं, नए पत्ते हमेशा ऊपर की ओर होते हैं, और जो पुराने पत्ते होते हैं वो नीचे की ओर होते हैं. You just check this stem, this leaf, it is at the lower portion of the stem, hence it is the older one. Whereas, just you see this leaf, very small in size because it is very new, and it is present at the top of the stem. Clear? So the older leaves are found at the lower part of the stem, whereas the newer or the younger leaves, it is found at the top of the stem. In standard 3, we all had discussed about the structure of leaf. Generally, we draw this type of leaf. This is the flat portion of the leaf, and this flat portion, which is expanded to the sunlight, which is upright towards the sunlight, जो बिल्कुल सीधे sun की तरफ face करता है. This area, which is flat in shape, it is known as leaf blade. What we called it? Leaf blade or leaf lamina also. plate or lamina. The flat portion of the leaf is known as leaf plate or lamina. Clear? Now, if you will notice a leaf, the leaf has a central line. The leaf has a central line, and this central line is known as mid rib. What we called it? Mid rib. Yeah. You can see the central line. This is your midrib. Clear to you? The leaf is having a strong central line, which is known as midrib, which is branched into many lateral and fine small vein like structure. And this, just like this one, you see many lateral or branched lines can you can see, which is coming out from the central line. And this point is this small lines are known as veins. What we called it? Veins. Clear to you? Now, the support which is present just at the back portion of the leaf and is attached with the stem, this portion is known as petiole. What we called it? Petiole. Clear to you? Ye aap dekho, this is your petiole. Clear to you? Ye petiole aapka stem se attached rehta hai, is tarah se, this way. Clear? This is your petiole. Done? Now, the pointed portion of the leaf, it is known as tip of the leaf. Check this one. This is the tip of the leaf. The edge. This is the edge of the leaf. This is the edge of the leaf. And this portion, this is the node of the stem. Now structure is clear. Now let's start the functioning of the leaves. What are the functions of leaf? As we all know, the leaf is known as the kitchen of plant. Leaf is known as the kitchen of the plant. It prepares the food. It prepares the food by the process of photosynthesis. So its main function is to cook the food, to prepare the food by using two raw materials, CO2 and H2O. As we all know, the CO2 is getting inside the leaf through the stomata from the atmosphere. As we all know, the carbon dioxide is present in atmosphere, and from the atmosphere carbon dioxide enter in the leaf through a small hole known as stomata. Water, it is drawing by the roots. The water and minerals, they are present in the soil, and in the soil roots are present. The roots draw the water and minerals, and it is being transported with the help of the stem. This is your stem, and this is the underground portion of the plant, which is known as root. As we all know, the water is present in the soil. This water is drawn by the root, and it is being transported with the help of the stem, and then it reaches the leaves for the process of photosynthesis. Now, in the leaves, we all have just now studied, there are many small branches, including a central one. The central one is known as midrib, and the lateral one is known as veins. Now, these veins help in the transportation of water and food material to their respective site.
Now you can see it is written in your textbook also. These veins help in transportation of the food material. They also provide support to the lamina. As we all know, the lamina is flat and broad. The lamina is flat and broad, and this flat structure, it is all because of the support given by the veins. These veins, which is coming out from the central line, it actually provides a skeletal structure. It provides a framework to support or to give the flat structure to the leaf. Clear? So, function of veins we have done. The veins help in transportation of food and water, as well as the veins provide a framework. It provides a framework for the support to the lamina. Lamina ko support karne ke liye ye ek framework deta hai. Theek hai? Now, the functions we all know, the main functions of the leaf is to prepare the food by the process of photosynthesis. Now, just to recapitulate the function of photosynthesis once again. What happens in photosynthesis? As we all know, the carbon dioxide and water, these are the two raw materials which are required to perform this function. But before that, just make yourself clear about the stomata. What is this stomata? Stomata is the tiny pore which is present on the leaf. Stomata is the tiny pore which is present on the leaf and which is guarded by two guard cells. Now what happens? When the sunlight falls on the leaves, the chlorophyll captures the sunlight and opens the guard cell. When the guard cells open, then there is a minute opening between the two guard cells. This is known as stomatal pore. What we called it? Stomatal pore. And through this pore only, exchange of gases takes place. Is opening se hi aapka kisi bhi gas ka exchange hota hai. Exchange of gases takes place. Now you see here, the surface of the leaves have tiny pores called stomata. These help in exchange of gases during respiration. Clear? So two functions. One is they cook the food for the plant. Second, the stomata help in exchange of gases not only for photosynthesis but for respiration also. What is the meaning of respiration? Just a similar process to breathing. Means the living plant, they also need oxygen to survive. Means the plants take carbon dioxide as well as take oxygen for the breathing process. Clear? So these are the two main functions of the leaf. Now there is an important topic, that is your venation. What is the meaning of venation? Venation means the arrangement of veins. Venation means the arrangement of veins in the leaf. Now you just check this two diagram. Here in most of the leaf, the veins are arranged in this way. Clear? But in banana leaf, if you will check, the leaves goes parallel. And in some of the leaves, all the veins goes like this. You can see the different arrangement of veins are there. The pattern of veins on the leaf is called leaf venation. The pattern of veins on the leaf is called leaf venation. If this is like a network on both the sides of the midrib,
The venation is called reticulate, as you have seen in the people. If the venation is going in both the directions, then it is known as reticulate venation. If the leaf has all veins parallel to each other, then it is known as parallel venation.
Check this one. If the veins are going in this type of direction, it is known as reticulate venation. What we called it? Reticulate. And this type of venation is found most of the plant. We have an example, peepal. But if a leaf is like this and all the venation it goes parallel to each other, then it is known as parallel venation. What we called it? Parallel venation. And we have an example, grass. Grass is a very good example of parallel venation. So depending upon the arrangement of veins, we have two type of venation. One is reticulate venation and the another one is parallel venation.
Function